0824. WhatsApp passport 081-248-0890. We fix fridges, washing machines, stoves, microwaves, and many more household appliances. We are small core of
all glory unto the life giver, creator of heaven and earth, the Almighty. Yeah! Rastafari.
Asia! The impossible, magda possible. Ba'ek kan nausan, as dia jasabal. The impossible, magda possible. Ay pavaitar yake enemy and my butt, yake obstacle.
This is the Business Hub live with Bevan Jacobs, and today I have the wonderful opportunity to have a co-host with me, Mr. Henry Prince of Radio Eastern. I must say, sir, thank you so much for this morning. It was a very wonderful interview, and thank you for joining in my show as well, where we take a recap of what happened in the month of July on the Business Hub, where we had amazing upcoming businesses like Uli Skawas, Black Flame, Rostec, Otto Wimpy, Mr. Keith Sudhaya, Smartman Sudhaya, Snowflake Energy Drink. Then we had Terry Ann Bowers, and we also had Ms. Glam South Africa, Janik, on the studio, in the studio. And we're just taking a recap of what we have learned from this guest. And like I said, today is not a normal show. We're just going to speak in general, teach, educate, and motivate the businesses up there on the Business Hub, where we try to celebrate and motivate the young and upcoming souls and entrepreneurs, businesses around East River and the community beyond. Like I said, you are tuned in to Radio East River, Onse Talent, Onse Stars, and Onse Mensa, and as if Onse WhatsApp messages hit, as if welcome on for Onse DM. Ze zullen zeggen op WhatsApp bij 064-536-9095. Is ingeschakeld bij Radio Eerste Revue, de Business Hub with Bevan Jacobs on this wonderful, nice sun shining Tuesday afternoon. If you have that message, please, you are welcome to pop us a message. You can also pop us an email voor die mensenkies wat daar bij die kantoor is. Mr. Henry, wat sê je vandaag voor ons?
Nee, glad niksie, man. Glad niksie. Ons is ingetuned. Alles. Ons is blij om die platform te hebben om weer eens te praten over bezigheid. Ouens, mannen en vrouwen in die gemeenschap wat hard werk om hulle bezigheid te bevorderen. En ook die platform te gebruiken van Radio Eerste Rivier om hulle bemarking te doen. So, ja, nee, het is een goede geleentheid.
Het is een goede geleentheid, en ik moet zeggen, the Business Hub have really educated that young entrepreneur sitting there at home, not knowing where to start, listening from this amazing, amazing, amazing guest that we had in studio for the month of July. Going forward, we are going to try and get every month, at the end of every month, we're going to do a recap, recoup, whatever is the right word for you. So success, soos my die gasten weet nou al, of die luisteraars weet nou al, die Business Hub so presenter, sy Engels is nie so fantasmagorisch nie, ons Engels is so eers soos eight times, en nou en dan ran het uit, ons het net een Engelse teacher gehad. So ons praat mengels on the Business Hub, you know. So, focusing on our first guest that we had, it was the team of Snowflake. Mr. Henry, van jou kant daarvoor, ek heb iets in my comments en commentaar lever op wat het ons in is. We're not judging today, it's not the same way we judge, we're just taking a recap of what we've learned out of that session, focusing on Snowflake, Energy, which was the first guest on this show.
Yes. Silver Snow Energy Drink, hulle was saam met ons, en dit was saam met Wondi, Plaasnaar en Mr. Damons. En hulle het hulle Snowflake kom present hier so op die show. Dit was 'n wonderlike geleentheid om hulle te ontmoet, en as ook om die Silver Snow Energy Drink te kon proe. En dat het zero, wat het die man nou gesê, zero aftertaste.
Zero aftertaste, which is supernatural.
Ja, het was, dit was een wonderlijke geleentheid om daar te kon proe in studio. En ek wil graag sê aan die luisteraars, dit is nie beskikbaar in elke area nie, maar daar is wel beskikbaar, jy kan het kry direct vanaf Plaasnaar, jy kan het kry direct vanaf Cedric Lungama.
Cedric Lungama.
Cedric Lungama as ook vanaf Mr. Damons. So hulle besonderhede is op ons Facebook page, hulle is ook op social media, so jy kan het direct van hulle afkry.
So yeah, so that is just basically about the product that Mr. Henry Prince has shared with us, and with the amazing guest that we have from the that we had, I think that was on Tuesday, 13th of July, 2021, that we had them. And we had the opportunity to have them in studio. It was Plaasnaar, Vondri, Cedric Lungama, and Mr. Randall Damons. What I've learned from that business arrangement that they have amongst them, it's that teamwork is very much an important role when it comes to running and marketing a business. So our listeners, what from my point of view, of my opinion, just to recap one of the things that I've learned from that business, there is so much what we say, understanding amongst one another. When they sat in studio, we could literally see how they enjoy one another's conversations.
The energy was there,
definitely. The energy was there. So, but having that good and great relationship, and what I want to get the feel from them on that day, and even with what they've said on the journey as they're going out advertising Silver Snow energy drink, which is a classic energy drink. We come in the form of a 250 ml bottle, which have a zero aftertaste, and it can be, there is a few stores where what they have mentioned that you can get it from, and that is what is amazing. They are just taking a product which was foreign to us, which we didn't know, and now they're just taking it to the marketing. So number one that I've learned from them, it's the teamwork that they are definitely having. Number two, another thing that I'm having that I've learned from them as ambassadors, what I know is that Plaasnaar and Vondi specifically, and Cedric Lungama, they are the socialite ambassadors, to call them, if I have to categorize them or give them a title, the socialite ambassadors of the brand. What I've learned from them is also that they are staying tuned to who they are. So we all know Plaasnaar is a comedian, Vondi is a rapper and an actor, and then Cedric Lungama, it's a TikTok star, amongst other things that he does, but yeah, they are staying true to who their characters are, irrespective if the responsibility for them is to advertise and promote their brand. So I wanna encourage and inspire all the entrepreneurs out there just to say that be true to you, stay positive. So number one we've learned from them is that teamwork is very much of important. If you are working in a group in your business, if you are more than one person, if you are 3-4 people, that it's very much important to have that teamwork amongst one another. Secondly, staying true to who you are. Any specific point from your side that stood out when we had them?
What I've picked up that they are passionate about their product. First of all, they believe in it. Secondly, they're passionate about it. So, and they also have the drive to push this brand. So amongst themselves, you can see that there's so much fire amongst the four of them. And coming with the senior member, Mr. Randall Damons, he is the one that actually, you can say, you don't need to push the guys. They know exactly what to do. And they believe in the product, and that's how they market it.
Yes. So just to add to latch on to what you said, and I think we can also put it as a point of what we've learned from them. You've made mention about Mr. Randall Damons, which I understand is the manager in the team, yeah, managing the artist also. It's very important to have that management person or person that is playing a management role, our leader type of role, to make sure that the team that is behind your brand or behind your product is keeping on track, being focused is very important thing when it comes to business. And when you do not decide on having that person is going to play or fulfilling that role of management, it's very scary to run a business or any product without having that leadership goals and so forth also in place. So On our second guest, we had Mr. Uli from Uli's Car was Mr. Ulrich Kotzen. In studio. What an amazing, humble man he is. Yeah. I mean, he is a person that is originally from Pretoria, as he have said with us, and if lost a business before or been in a business previously, and he came out to East River and just decided that he's going to start this amazing car wash that we, luckily for us, that is here close to Sainsbury Square. The car wash is here in Sainsbury Square where you can have them. Uli's Car Wash, what can you say from him, Mr. Prince?
Like you said, Uli is a very humble person, and if you look at their product, it's a good product that they're having here, and they also with the chemicals and stuff that they use to clean your car, once your car goes in the dirt, you can come, you can have your shopping at your luxury at Sainsbury Square, leave your car at Uli's and go back and pick it up. It will shine.
Definitely.
It can be a rainy day, but you will definitely see the sunlight on that car once it's clean.
Yes, yes, definitely. So, obviously, what is amazing for me, what stood out for me from Mr. Ulrich Kotzenberg, that he has as an entrepreneur, which I think in today's society, it's much important, and even in future, wherever you go as an entrepreneur, it's important to be humble. Get this Mr. Uli here, owner of a car, was doing quite well for himself, sitting here in studio, being so humble, having a conversation which you can converse with, in where you can feel the true essence of his character, the open spirit that he have. So you sitting there at home, being an entrepreneur, an upcoming star in the economic world, in the business world, it's much important to be humble in the business, irrespective of what type of business you're running, irrespective of how big or how small your business is, irrespective of how great you are as an entrepreneur. Humbleness is key. They say humbleness is the first key that you need to open any door for you. Don't be like, and I hope I'm not going to step on any toes, people of color in general, we have this boastful, and I'm speaking about myself as well, so I'm going to put myself in that boat as well, because we have this boastful attitude when we have achieved this little bit of success. Dan voelen ze me nou nee, man Henry, ze kan niet meer van mij vertellen.
Ja, maar ik moet net bijvoegen dat Bevan, jij is gedressed to kill vandaag, jong. Wat gaat dan aan?
They say dress up, speak up, so you can get up. There's a saying like that, dress up, speak up, and get up.
and go.
So
do your business.
Just to add in that this morning I felt like, listen, I haven't been dressing up in quite a while, so it's very much important when you, I think it's the English men that say, when you feel good, you look good, and when you look good, you do good. It's very much important for an entrepreneur, sometimes, you know, nowadays we don't live in this society where we have to be collared and tie. I mean, fashion, we're not talking, we're going a little bit off the topic, but just so for fun, interested now that...
Yeah, presentation is key.
Presentation is key in business, and one of those guests that we had actually stood very out, was outstanding when it comes to presentation, but we're going to come a bit later into that. We're still focusing on Mr. Uli. Yes, so he's had a very, very humble,
spirit.
And speaking to us was... plain, you know, you can so you it's a
was it's a very easy it was a very easy person. Interview
In being humble, I mean, it can teach and give you that opportunity for being approachable, because I mean, you are an entrepreneur, you are a business person, you are a businesswoman, you are a businessman. It is going to be impossible if you're going to be all this grumpy person, you're going to be a person of pride, you're going to be like somebody that just landed from space, Jupiter, Uranus, or wherever you're coming from. How are we going to buy from you? How are we going to approach you? How are we going to use or make use of your service if you are not humble like that? I mean, if I should walk into a car wash or drive into a car wash like that, and I mean, yes, the owner, and even if you visit his business, you will see that it's quite often that he is really hands-on with his business. He's there. He's humble with his staff as well. You will definitely enjoy your service like that.
He definitely believe in an open door policy.
Open door policy, and
you're free to come and speak to him regarding any products that you need to clean your car. He's also there to give advice.
Mm. So that was Mr. Ulrich Kotzenberg, the founder and CEO of Uliskawas, which is situated at Sainsbury Square Mall. We just want to take a break quickly. So if you have any questions about our guest, about the show, or about anything with regards to the business hub with Bevan Jacobs, you are welcome to WhatsApp Radio East River on 064-536-9095. And remember, you can also online do online streaming on our website, which is www.radioeasterriver.co.za. Onze stasi, onze talent en onze mensen. Sien vir jou nou by na die breek, bly ingeskakel.
Dis hy.
Yeah.
Got the Business Hub with Bevan Jacobs, and you are still tuned to, I want to say, Cape Town, oh, South Africa, most wanted radio station, not most wanted in the sense of, if it's a criminal police files, but I'm most wanted, this is the radio station, you must double. Definitely, you must watch us. You
die
must radio
station for the nation.
The radio station for the nation, for our station, our talent and our people. Remember, you are tuned into Radio Eerste, our station, our talent and our people. As you have a question for us, can you for us WhatsApp by 064-536-9095. And today's focus on this show, or the emphasis of this show, is to recap on what we have been discussing and talking to, and what we've learned from our guest of the month of July. So, Mr. Prince, jy's nog bly om hier saam met my te wees op die show?
Ja, kasie.
So we had a wonderful lady, Mrs. Terry Ann Brouwers, which we spoke about mental health issues as well. So, and that was a much needed conversation that we had, because nowadays entrepreneurs deal with the situation of where they are not mentally stable to learn, or not to learn to run the businesses. And I think the problem that we nowadays having as entrepreneurs is that we are in denial when it comes to your mental stability, because there is een van de goede wat Terry Ann discussed met ons is, ons is bang om te confess that you need help, and you're scared to come forward and to say, luister eens, man, ik is in mijn old day, nie, man. Because running a business, it's like, you run this business, but you have to compete in society, you have to compete in your industry where you're at, you have to compete in the market, you have that stress of dealing with finances, of advertising your product, marketing your product, you have that stress of creating an income with profit for yourself, and if you are in that position where you have staff already, you have that problem also of being profitable every month. Anything from your side that you've learned from that interview?
I think that interview was a learning curve for all of us. We have to admit when we're going off the rail. And it's difficult to see as a proud business owner not to admit that he's mentally not capable anymore to run his business. And like she have discussed, and the topic she have touched on is that you have to be honest with yourself. You have to admit that you're not able to mentally run your business and get help.
So my advice to you normally is what I can definitely tell these young and upcoming entrepreneurs, it's very much important to understand that you will never be able to run a business on your own. And even if you are in a space where it's only you, it's very important to get what we call it, the business coach. And if you cannot afford one, get a mental coach, or get somebody that is more successful to what you are, to take your head and walk that journey with you. Because When it comes to a business, it's absolutely crazy to run a business in today's time, especially with the pandemic that's also being completely and literally taking our lives and our accents, our movements, our ways of trades, everything that the pandemic just took it over. Kan enige iemand mal drive?
Yeah, definitely.
Soveel woorde te sê. So it's very much important to have that coach do that. And one thing that we've learned that I've mentioned from Terry and is to come out, come forward and to admit, listen, I have a problem. I'm not mentally stable to run a business. And when you come to that stage and you find, she also spoke about this presence and the sign of this presence. And one thing she said, if you find yourself in a room, you're mentioning earlier, you said about you dressed up, whatsoever, we made fun of it. Find yourself in you find yourself in a closed room. Jy is nie lus om uit te gaan nie. Jy is nie meer lus om te gaan jou produk te gaan bemark nie. Jy is net nie meer lus vir die dag nie. Jy dink jy het maar net 'n afdag, but deep down inside of you, you don't know that you actually
busy
going into depression, and that's a scary thing for an entrepreneur to be in. Ek wil gewoon net 'n vraag vra. Ek weet nie of mens daar iets weet nie. Now we'll be talking about depression. What is the two most important things? Not the two common things that entrepreneurs dies from.
If it comes to depression.
If it comes to in general, not in depression, in general.
In general. Taking their own lives. That's
definitely one. Definitely. Yeah. Look, to say stats and scientists have proven that the two most common things, or the two fashionable things that entrepreneurs or business owners can die from, it's an instant heart attack, because they just stress too much. They go absolutely crazy. They get an immediately heart attack. There's so many entrepreneurs. You can go read up on articles that heart attacks is one of the fundamental things that entrepreneurs die from. And the next thing is definitely depression and anxiety leading you up to take your own life, going to so far to take your own life. So that it was it from Terry and Browse, and our topic on that day was that we spoke about mental health issues or mental health in general amongst entrepreneurs and even people in general. Then we had Wumpy. Oh, I must say that coffee was great. She brought us some coffee.
I didn't get the coffee.
Ons moet later 'n draai gaan maak en gaan vra daar. Waar is die koffie? So, ja, wat het jy geleer van die dame van Wimpy wat by ons kom kuier het? The franchise owner of Wimpy, of the newly renovated, not newly renovated, the newly opened Wimpy in Sanbury Square.
What I've learned about them is their passion to drive their business. They obviously have worked hard to establish this business, and this is not their only one. They have other branches as well. So they well established, and they're on par with, if you look outside with how the business trending now, they on par with that level, because how the way they do their marketing and how they run their business, they on par. So they're doing excellent with their business and even running Wimpy.
Remember, you are still tuned to Radio Easter of here, which is onze station, onze talent, onze mensen. Die radio station is wat jong en opkomende artists, jong en opkomende entrepreneurs en local mensen zoals ik en jij probeer vat naar die next level door baie goeie broadcasting te bring on live streaming on www.radioeesterhoeve.co.za. If you have a question to any of us in the studio, even to myself, with regards to the business app, or any question that you have for any of our previous guests that were on our show, you are welcome to WhatsApp or us on 064-536-9095. And for those who want to send the email, you are welcome to send the email to info@radioeesterhoeve.co.za. And remember, the Business Hub is a show where we try to inspire, motivate, and celebrate young and upcoming entrepreneurs and teach them not to give up, teach them not to give in, and motivate them to keep that hustle going. This is the Business Hub live with Bevan Jacobs and with my co-host for today, Mr. Henry Prince. Henry Prince has put me in the studio. Mr. Prince, one thing about Wimpy that I can definitely say is what I've learned. I never actually knew that the coffee is imported. Never. I always thought that it's a local coffee. From what I learned from the lady that was here, that said the famous coffees and what type of coffees they're serving, famous beans. It's actually imported from Brazil, you know. So with the business hub, we could actually, the business hub on Radio Easter, I actually found out that for the first time I was stunned, because I always thought I'm just drinking coffee that they bought around the corner from any local coffee supplier, but it's never the case. They actually have very good coffees, you understand. So also one thing that I've learned from the lady that was here, it's like, never be scared to relocate. She and her husband co-owns the branch here at Sainsbury Square. They actually originally from Durban. And there's one thing that we as entrepreneurs are scared for. When you go for your business idea or your business plan or whatever you inspire might give you that challenge to relocate. So, and then we're scared, we were thinking about, I have too much to lose, I have too much friends to lose, I have too much history to lose, I have that. Let me tell you now, if you have an idea and you believe 150% that it can work and it requires you to move, get up and move. No one will bring that opportunity to you when you sit in one place. I mean, they're doing well. If you walk past Wimpy, you will see that it's full. There is people around. They are serving coffees. They are serving the greatest of breakfast. They're serving the greatest lunch. But it would have never happened to them if they didn't decide to take the chance and take that risk and move. Yeah. You cannot sit on one place. I'm a Durbanite. I cannot go to Cape Town. It doesn't work like that. Nee, ek is 'n Cape Townian. Ek kan nie hier na die Karoo plek toe gaan om my besigheid daar gaan te gaan nie, want wat gaan my vriende sê? They are not going to be there when you struggle. They are not going to be there if you fail. They are not going to be there if your children is going hungry. They are not going to be there if your rent is late. Get up and move. One thing that I've definitely learned from that lady, from Wimpy. So it was amazing to have her. She has a very humble spirit as well. Yeah. She say along with what we've talked about when it comes to Ulrich, she and Ulrich have something in common. Humbleness galore. Humbleness galore. There's also one thing that I always thought that, and ik wil niet lachen, ik heb altijd gedacht that people are owners of this big franchises. They will walk up in here with the suit and tie and collar and whatsoever. So I literally thought that this lady's going to come in here with a briefcase and whatsoever van een one piece owner. She came in here with a nice pair of tackies, jeans and tights, simple. And that was also for me something which I take it was amazing for me. Like Capitec said, simplicity, the saying of Capitec goes, simplicity is the ultimate sophistication. And when she was sitting here in studio having that interview, and I'm literally like, but this is a Wimpy, I'm telling myself in my mind, but this is a Wimpy owner. This is a Wimpy franchise owner. She was simple, but that simpleness of her made her sophisticated. So that is something that we can say, and I'm copying, and I hope Capitec is not going to sue us. the slogan of Capitec when it says, simplicity is the ultimate sophistication. Be simple, irrespective of what type of business you earn, irrespective of what type of person you are. Be simple. Anything you want to add on that with a lady of besides the I fact think that you didn't get your coffee.
Yeah, I think they're doing well. My call to the community of East River would be, please come out and support them.
Yes, definitely. And I mean, they're serving great coffees. They're also having specials on there. You are also, and they've also make mention that for the people that is not in the nowadays in liking to go out, to go to a mall and go sit and eat out, they made it possible in a city like Easter River to make delivery service available. They also partnered up with Uber Eats, and you are also welcome to, just as you use Uber to drive from one place to another place, you can actually use Uber Eats to order in for coffee, your favorite coffee with Wimpy, your favorite breakfast with Wimpy. That is amazing. And for the record, for those who didn't know, the business hub with Bevan Jacobs on Radio Easter River can definitely confirm with you that this Wimpy here is the first in the history of Easter River, if I'm correct.
Yes.
Speaking under correction,
yes, definitely.
The records is the first Wimpy in the history of Easter. The closest one that we have here is out in Kales River, Zevenwag Mall. So now the community of Easter River can have that opportunity to have a restaurant like that, of that calibre, right around the corner. Yeah, so we had Black Flame. Sure. What an amazing opportunity. What an amazing opportunity that lady have in her hand. She is, they are absolutely amazing. So we had Danielle and I can't remember the lady, the other lady's name. I'll get to her name now. So we had the two of them, the owners and the directors of Black Flame, which is a tailor-made jewelry store. They make anything with your, they just create magic with your type of rings and so forth. I must say one thing that they have shared with us is that partnership that they're having is absolutely amazing. They understand each other, Candace Venter and Daniel Cronje. My humble apologies for that. Candace Venter and Daniel Cronje, the directors Cronje. He's a very groot Afrikaanse fan. So, yeah. So, with sharing the history of Black Flame, Candace have taught us that Black Flame was first in the entertainment industry. They were in the entertainment industry, and so they diversified. So what happened is that she had this idea of this jewelry business. She was first in the entertainment world. She had that name, and she decided she wanted to venture into this business. I must say with you, in COVID, there is people that have diversified, which I've learned. That what I've learned from them is that don't be scared to diversify. So as you know, a bower is, for example, there's a lot of work for builders out there. If you are a builder and you can tiling work doen, but you see that the tiling opportunity is actually going to bring in more business for you, why do you still want to be a builder? And that's one thing that I've learned from her, that she wasn't scared, they weren't scared to diversify from one industry to another industry. And I mean, from entertainment to jewelry, it's a total different business. Anything from your side that you learn from the two ladies from Black Flame Innovation?
Actually, how did the name come about? When they were driving and she saw this black car passing, and she just had the idea, it has to be Black Flame.
Yes. Yeah, so we were fascinating and we were discussing amongst each other. We wonder where the name Black Flame Innovation comes from. And she said she was driving on the R300, if I can remember the story correctly. And she said that she didn't have a name and she was adamant to have this perfect name that could be attached, that's going to be stand out to a business. And she said she saw a car drove past, a black car.
Sports car.
Black sports car drove past her.
And the flames came out.
Flames in the car had come. And the car was swat. And she said, that's the name. And she said to herself, Black Flame. And after that, she said, that's the name to the business, which is Black Flame Innovation. And they are also situated in Shanbury Square Mall here in East River, the newly opened business. One thing that I've really admired from that interview is how she said about of Sierra friend. She actually had two very important friends in her life to help her with the business. The one is currently an employer of a company or helping her out in the business, and the other one is a partner now in the business, which became the investor, because when she started, she said she didn't have the money whatsoever. So having great friends in your circle, having that friends that can be able to help you with your business, because nowadays you have that friends the only one to get something from you.
Yes.
The only one to get something out of you. If you are entrepreneur, let me scare you a bit off. You must be prepared to walk the lonely life. Because entrepreneurship is not for the party person. Entrepreneurship is not for the person who's just living from a Monday to Friday and Saturday kijk, hey, wat gaat ons vandaag doen? Waar is mijn brasa? It doesn't work like that. Entrepreneurship is 24/7. It's walking up, it's waking up, walking. Is waking up, hiking. It's waking up, understanding that you're going to walk this journey sometimes or most of the times alone. And let me even scare you off. Sometimes you come up with a business plan, you come up with an idea, you come up with a product. Not even your family is going to believe in you. So hulle gaan vir jou sê, nee, jy het nie man, jy is mal man. Jy moet nie die ding try nie. So the one thing that I've learned from is very important to have that friends in your circle that motivates you, that can help you out. And I mean, just the one thing, having the right friends around you. And they have also made mention that one statement that stood out of that conversation for me was, if you, and I think Danielle mentioned that, she said that if you are the most motivated person in your circle, then you need to get out of that circle. Because who's going to motivate you?
Yes.
If nobody motivates...
Definitely.
If nobody motivates each other. So negativity, there's no room for growth in a space like that. And I added on that interview on that. If you are hanging out with 5 millionaires, you will definitely become the sixth one. If you are hanging out with 5 successful people, you will become the sixth person that's going to be successful. And making sure you're making... the right friends, living in the right circle, living in the right surroundings, making sure that, so that you can make sure that your business don't fail at the end of the day. Is there anything from your side that you want to take us through with regards to the product? I must also say, we don't take jewelry, we don't understand the power that a piece of metal, let me call it that, whether it's silver, whether it's gold, can have on our souls. But with the interview with Black Flame Innovation, they actually made me realize what an important role a piece of silver can play in our roles. Sometimes we walk in people's houses and we see, it's a nice silver ring, it's a nice necklace. And we just think that there is no meaning towards it. And they actually made me realize that there are actually consumers or clients or people out there who's actually having some bigger meaning to what they buy, to what pieces they buy when it comes to jewelry. So it made me understand that they have clients walking in there that orders custom-made rings, customized necklaces that they actually want to keep from one generation to another generation. So, and she actually made me realize for next time when I'm going to go buy any type of piece of jewelry, I'm not going to just go buy. You must have meaning to what you want to buy. Sometimes you must have meaning and not just buy anything and just play around with it. So great service they have there in studio whatsoever. So that is Black Flame Innovation, which is situated in Sanbury Square Mall, that Candace Venter, Daniel Cronje. If you have any questions for us, you can tune into WhatsApp 064-536-9095. You can send us an email as well at info@radioeasterriver.co.za. We're just going to take a break quickly, and then we're going to go over the last guest that we have there. You are still tuned to the Business Hub with Bevan Jacobs live on Radio Easter River. WhatsApp us on 064-536-9095. Stay tuned.
Kiss it better. now or never. Ooh, yeah. If you wanna taste, come get it right. Kiss it better. It's now or never.
Mr. Henry Prince, you are live streaming on www.radioeersterriver.co.za. Onze stasie, onze talent en onze mensen en ons is so dankbaar om vir jou deur hierdie dinsdagmiddag te vat, sonnagmiddag in die Weskaap, in die Kaap. Ons wil net vir meneer Denzel Williams sê, wat daar op Facebook, sy Facebookblad, kommentaar gelewe, hy sê, so glad you guys are helping our upcoming businesses, men and women. Mr. Williams, we at Radio Easter River says we are doing it with pleasure. We know and understand how much our community need that this. Joel Vessels sê, good afternoon, hulle sê, oh, good afternoon, allemaal. Amal in the studio, Joel Vessels. Good afternoon to you as well from us in studio. Mr. Franklin Frankenstein, DJ Frankenstein is in the house. Baie dankie dat DJ Frankenstein in the house is. Mr. Henry Prince, ons het ook van meneer Jason Ross gehad van RTI, die BMW special. Wat het ons specialist, wat het ons van hom geleer van jou kant af?
Ons het geleer dat hy man staan vir baie dinge, maar hy staan vir sy beleid om sy customers happy by sy deure uit te laat gaan. En 'n baie humble besigheidsman, 'n ou wat die kliënte se behoefte eerste plaas voordat hy dink aan sy behoefte. Jason, a very good friend of mine, RTI is also servicing my car, and you receive good service from them, because the moment you walk into their place in Blackheath, you get acknowledged, because some business owners, they will see you come in and they won't acknowledge you. They send the youngest guy go speak to the people there, but he as the owner will walk up to you and welcome you, and that's a good sign. He's a very humble person, like I said, and RTI I've been with them since 2019, and I can say that they are doing us proud.
Definitely. So from Mr. There's two things that was outstanding from me, from Jason, Mr. Jason W. Ross, is that he says that in business you must be very disciplined when it comes to handling your finances, very, very disciplined. And he's also, een ding wat van my uitgestaan het van hom is, that he sees himself as a doctor, and he sees your vehicle as a patient, which was very amazing for me. So it shows you that it doesn't treat your vehicle as something that is that, and that is what is making his service such a service of being alive, that you can literally feel like, it's not a mechanic wat net my gejaar wil hê nie, maak my kar reg en dan ry net om my draai en dan is het stuk in nie. Another thing that he said to me, which was outstanding, he said none of his employers is going to start work. Niemand van sy guys wat by hom gaan werk, gaan in 'n kar raak, unless hulle nie gebid het nie. So it also shows me that he is a man of faith, and also that one thing that we as young and upcoming entrepreneurs can learn from him is that irrespective of what your faith belief is, it's also to turn to the faith side of your life, and also understanding that you cannot just be a successful person out of the flesh and out of the natural gifts that you will have. And there's something that he mentioned is that, I can still hear his voice in my head where he said, your gift will make room for you, but you must also attach your gift to the faith side of who you are, and turn and turn your successes or whatever you're expecting from your business from the man above. So that was from Jason. Anything from your side? From Jason.
I think we have said it all. Jason is definitely RTA.
Yes, he's RTA.
His heart bleeds for BMW and his clients, and he's a specialized doctor, as you mentioned. He's a specialized doctor in that field. He also gives free advice. I've seen a lot of BMW groups on Facebook where he actually give advice on certain type of vehicles, what to look out for, what to change before your car breaks down, oil services, all of that he makes available free of charge on Facebook. So not only is he a businessman that believe in making money? You have to make money. Any businessman have to make money. But he also believe in sharing of information. And that's key. He share his gifts. Not everybody will give your secret away. But he does it because he believe that the people that support him will always support him because of the type of service that they deliver to the public.
Of course, yes. So that was about Mr. Jason Ross. Then we had the guy from Mr. Keats is his name, from Smart Man Sudhaya, which came and spoke to us with regards to his business. And one thing that we focused, or that I can remember that we focused about on in that interview, was that nowadays businesses like his Calabra, because his business is in general renting out suits, and that his business is struggling at this point of time with the type of with events being down, etc. So one thing that we've learned from him is that not to give up. They haven't closed doors, I said. They just kept on going during this tried and tested time. Anything from your side when it comes to Smart Man Sudhaya?
I would say Sudhaya in general at the moment, like weddings are down, parties are down. The only thing now is funerals, where people support them. But with the parties being cancelled and social distancing and all of these things, these type of businesses are struggling out there. And but like he said, you have to have faith and you have to believe that things will get better.
So that was from Smart Man Sudhaya. Then we had a super amazing our last guest that we had, the last guest we're going to talk about. I think we've covered everybody. We had a super amazing lady from Easterhove itself, which is currently competing in Miss Glam South Africa. Miss Glam South Africa, just to give you a little bit of background to everyone around Easterhove in the surrounding areas who's listening, Miss Glam South Africa is a pageant that is all about woman entrepreneurship, a woman who's in business themselves, a woman who is trying to become a successful entrepreneur. So Miss Glam South Africa is also well known for the magazine Glam. The contestants of Miss Glam South Africa can learn a lot about being a boss woman, and doing charity is one of the well-known things that they do. They're all about giving back to people who brought you to where you are today. They have normally have meetings on Saturdays. They have sponsorships across the country, and they are also a partner, have partnership with Miss South Africa, etc. So I think for me it was outstanding, because I was thinking one of our producers here at the studio, Mr. Josh, said to me, you need to interview this lady. And I was thinking, like, what is a pension to do in a business? So when I read about a little bit about Ms. Glam South Africa, I thought, like, wow. What I think about, what I've learned about out of this interview with this lady is that you can definitely, that it is something unique to have a pension, because a pension is also the kind of pension that Dunkos and model was model, but at the same time they're trying to teach
business skills
to young and upcoming artists, which is in modeling. Because I think for me that is absolutely crazy, because as you know, Dunk and no offense to people who's in the pension industry, models under normal circumstances, people just want to model, they don't want to do anything else. pensions like that in Cape Town and the surrounding areas, wat kan voor jou leer hoe om een entrepreneur te raken. Dus so that was very amazing. She also was she's a person in terms of that have taught me, especially when I sit down. She was so outspoken en normally ze moest op de radio gaan, dat ze schaam. En wat the moment zij in de studio gekomen, toen zij outspoken, you know, and she have the support of her family. She also taught us what is the importance of having the back of your family when you do anything, whether you're in a pension or like what we're focusing on is entrepreneurship. Having the support of your family is very important. Anything from your side?
I think if you look at them, they get coached. They are trained how to handle their business and how to go about it, public speaking and also when you're going to open up and maybe start your own business, then you're ready to go and open your business. I mean, you get trained to be a model, but you also get trained how to handle your business and also how to present yourself to the public. So the coaching side of that is very important.
Very, very important. Thank you so much, Mr. Henry Prince. We want to say thank you to everyone that have tuned in to our recap of July 2021. We're looking forward to our show on Thursday. And remember, our show on Thursday is a bit earlier, so you don't want to miss out. We have an exciting guest lined up for you, which you can watch follow our Facebook page. We will definitely make mention who our guest is going to be. Make sure that you are tuned in. Make sure that you tell your neighbor, your friend, your family, allemaal daar by die huis, allemaal by die werk, allemaal by die school, wat in die school is, wat in die land of whatever, wat luister na die besigheid. So maak seker dat you let them know. Here is a show on Radio Eerste Rivier that is helping us and teaching and educating and at the same while celebrating our young and upcoming entrepreneurs of Eerste Rivier and the surrounds. Any last words from your side, Mr. Prince?
All I'm going to say is, soos J.O. altijd sê, onse mense is jou mense. So, mense bly ingeskakel, ons hardloop nog live op ons website, so luister na Radio Eerste Rivier, download die app op Google Play Store en volg ons op Facebook en baie dankie dat julle ingeskakel het om tyd te maak saam met ons saam Mr. Bevan Jacobs op die Business Hub en dan sien ons julle donderdagochtend 11:00 weer hier terug. Bye, dankie. Lekker dag verder.
Yes. So, we know, every time before we close the show officially, we say a quote on every, we try to say a quote on every show of our show. The quote today for every entrepreneur, every business person, every upcoming star, every upcoming hustler, whatever you name yourself, every upcoming king, this is our quote for today. Any active businessman has to be very focused. You've got to be in the right frame of mind. If your energy is diverted in various directions, you do not achieve the results. You need to know when to switch on and when to switch off, and the rest of the things that happen around that. Business is in the foreground. The rest is in the background. Stay focused. Stay tuned. This was the Business Hub with Bevan Zeker. Thank you so much, Mr. Henry Prince. Radio Eerste Rivier. Onze stasie, onze talent, onze mensen. Stay tuned. Thank you so much.